Well, now I have to control my tears. Well, I'm very moved by the whole ceremony and the beauty of what's going on between these walls. Well, I will try my best. My very dear friends, President Kate, Chancellor Thibault, members of Senate, faculty, graduates, and students of the University of Lethbridge. It is with a sense of immense pride and gratitude that I accept this honor today. I thank you from the bottom of my heart. This honorary degree means more to me than you can know, not only because I am the first Yiddish writer to be honored in this way by a Canadian university, but also because this Doctor of Laws is the very first university degree that I have ever been awarded. So, in a sense, this convocation ceremony this morning is a celebration of my graduation as much as it is a celebration for those of you being granted your bachelor degrees. In fact, I could never have imagined an honor that more completely answers my innermost wishes, fantasies, and desires. Because the sad fact is that I never attended a university. I never sat in a brightly lit classroom absorbing information from professors who were experts in their fields. I never haunted libraries in search of books to help me write my papers. I never stayed up all night working on assignments, nor studied for exams with my classmates. My university was the Second World War. My classroom was the Lodz Ghetto. My teachers were my fellow inmates there, and especially the poets, painters, intellectuals of the doomed writers' community, incarcerated between the barbed wire walls of the ghetto, who accepted me at a very early age as a member. So I am a graduate of the Holocaust, of the death camps of Auschwitz and Bergen-Belsen. I have matriculated in one of the greatest tragedies known to man. I have a degree from no other university, at least not until today. I do not want to dwell on the horrors of the past, but if you will permit me just one more word of homage to my own language, because it too was a victim of the war, and because through me you are conferring an honor on this doomed language as well. That language is Yiddish. I write in Yiddish because it was the language of my home in Poland. It was the language of my childhood and my community. It was the language I knew like the map of my own heart. So I wrote my novels in Yiddish out of a sense of loyalty to the vanished world of my youth, out of a sense of obligation to a world that no longer existed. Little did I realize that in a few short years, Yiddish itself would no longer exist, at least not as I knew it, not as a living and breathing language of day-to-day life. To lose one's language is an unspeakable, painful thing, especially for a writer. Writing is always a lonely profession, but the Yiddish writer's loneliness has an additional dimension. Her readership has perished. Her language has gone out with the smoke of the crematoria. She creates in a vacuum, almost without a readership, out of fidelity to a vanished language, as if to prove that Nazism did not succeed in extinguishing that language's last breath, and that it is still alive. And so here I am, a Yiddish writer on the prairies, a Yiddish writer who must depend on translation in order to be read, a Yiddish writer who has longed all her life for a formal education and an opportunity to belong to an academic community. And here in Lethbridge, so far away from where my life's journey began, as if by magic, that wish has been granted to me. Suddenly, I have been given the opportunity at the age, at the young age of 83, that I no longer expected ever to receive, of having a university degree, and what is more, it is a degree conferred on me by the wonderful institution in this peaceful and pleasant city that I now call home. This degree that I and you, my dear graduates, are receiving today is a sign of our joining the community of scholars and achievers, of those who have attained an education that is also too often taken for granted in this free country of Canada. Now you might look at me and say, this lady has lived a long life and she has written books and won prizes and made something of a name for herself, all without a university education. But what I want to tell you is that I am living proof of how easy the right to an education can be taken away, of how fragile a thing education is, subject to the vagaries of discrimination and prejudice, to the whims of politics, war, and upheavals. You may be thinking to yourself, surely this can never happen in Canada. And I certainly hope that what I have lived through can never happen here. But then, who would have imagined that the devastation and horrors of the Holocaust would have happened in the heart of civilized Europe? And yet, they did. But this is not the time to talk about horrors of war and the pain of a dying language. This sunny, happy day is really dedicated to celebration of achievements and of the future. I wish you all the best, my dear graduates, as you embark on your futures. You have worked hard, you have earned this chance to kick up your heels a little and to face the future with optimism. But please remember that the future grows out of the past, and the past too must be remembered, if only for the lessons it has to teach us, namely what to celebrate and what to fear. So I wish you much joy, my fellow degree holders, my much fortitude and good fortune in meeting the cold, cynical, complex, wonderful, exciting world that lies outside the walls of this institution. Thank you.